Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at how you can export objects as videos from Cartoon Animator 4 and then composite them as layers into an Adobe Premiere project where we'll then apply some basic enhancement effects. The project we have on the screen right now is composed of a number of different props that make up both the foreground and the background of our project. There are also two characters facing each other, which we will also include in our final composite. You can see the scene has basic animation as well. We're going to explore a couple of different ways to export props from your scene. The first method is a traditional export. There are two ways you can get to the render window. The first is to select render video or image from the drop-down render menu, and the other is to simply select it from your toolbar. Once the render settings window is open, you can go between both image and video render sections. In the image section, you can choose various image export formats, as well as whether or not you want to export a sequence or current frame. You can also export a transparent PNG sequence to be used in Adobe Premiere as well. Below that, you can choose output size resolution, as well as the frame range that you want to export. Under video, you can now select MOV as a video format, which allows you to export transparent video with alpha data. You'll need to ensure that you select the transparent video checkbox in order to do so. As with the image section, you also have output size and range. I'm going to start by exporting the entire project range to MOV video format without transparent video. Once it's finished rendering, we can give it a quick playback to see the whole scene complete with camera animation. Let's take a look next at basic hierarchical output, using the new Isolate Selection feature. We can multi-select all of the props in both the foreground and the background as a group in order to move them simultaneously, but if you want to make everything invisible except for the prop you have selected, simply select the prop you want to isolate and then go up to select Isolate Selection from the toolbar, or simply use the I hotkey. Once Isolate Selection is enabled, then only the item that is selected will appear on the screen. You can multi-select consecutive items in the Scene Manager by holding the Shift key, and also select or deselect individual items by holding the Control key. Let's select the foreground objects all together, and then also select our little human dude standing on the mushroom. I'm going to export them all separately as an MOV video, this time enabling transparent video, and only exporting the frame range of our project. Once the export is finished, we can play back and now see our human character saying hello to an empty black void, which is actually the transparent part of the video. I'm going to repeat this process two more times, ensuring that both the output resolution and frame range remain the same. The first render I'm doing for the background items, and the second I'll do separately for just the monster. Here's the final output from our background item render, and here's the output from the monster only layer. Once we have all of our transparent video components, it's time to import them into Adobe Premiere for some additional editing and effects. Let's add the three separate videos to our project first, and then click and drag them one by one into the timeline. If we play back the first time, you'll notice that things are a little off, and the reason why is because we've imported the videos in the incorrect layer order. Let's click and drag our clips into the correct order, and play back again for the correct result. Once we're happy with that, we can add some basic special effects to our scene in Premiere. Let's start with the background layer, where I'm going to add a blur. I'll just make sure that the background clip is selected, and then search for Blur in the Effects tab. If I double-click on the Gaussian blur, it will apply to the clip, and then I can go ahead and adjust the blurriness level to my liking. A bit of blur on the background layer simulates a sort of depth of field effect, making it seem like that layer is further back. Next, let's use blur again, but this time to simulate a motion blur on our monster when he's jumping. For this one, we'll need to use keyframes to adjust the timing of the blur. Let's go to the frame right before he appears on the screen with his jump and add a keyframe. Then, set the blur level up. We want to ensure that we're using vertical blur here, as that's the direction he's jumping. As he reaches the apex of his jump, then I'll adjust the blur down a bit, which will automatically add a keyframe there on the clip. And finally, as he lands, I can set it back to 0, which will add our final keyframe. The result is a makeshift motion blur as our monster appears on the screen. Finally, I'm going to adjust the color tone of the foreground to differentiate it a bit from the other layers. This time, I'm going to add an RGB curve effect, which will allow me to tweak those values to give the foreground a higher amount of contrast from the warmer faded background. This is a quick example of how you can utilize the Isolate Selection tool and Transparent MOV Video Output to quickly assemble a scene and use separate effects in your video editing software to further enhance the look of your final project. As always, guys, be sure to check out our Learning Center for more tutorials on the latest features, as well as our forums over at forum.reallusion.com. I'll see you in the next video.